Hey YouTube, this is your girl Lady L here, and I am doing another weight loss video request. This video was requested by JBells1. The request was what to do when you feel tempted to eat or if you binge for a few days during your diet. I've been through this a couple of times for a very long time. After I had my kids, I was on yo-yo diets for about 3 or 4 years, on a diet, off a diet, on again, back again, lose weight, gain it back. So I know the trials and tribulations of yo-yo, and I know the trials of being tempted and binging also. Let's hit the first question is, what to do when you feel tempted to eat? Temptation is all around us, especially if you're in multi-family home, you have other people living with you, husband, kids, mom, dad, sister, brother, however it may be. But you're in a situation where one person prepares the meal and everybody eats. Or you may be at work, school, and anywhere basically and be tempted by this. And to answer this the best way possible is you have to, if you're in a multi-family situation, living with different people, even roommates and whatnot, you have to prepare your own meals. Point blank, period. You cannot be tempted because they may not be on the same journey as you. So family, you know, everybody in a perfect world, everybody wants their family to eat salads and grilled chicken and baked fish and all this with them. But the reality is not everybody's going to get on board right away. So you have to set the example and prepare your own meals. This is for the home situation. Work situation, same thing. You have to, you know, we have coworkers who want to go out to work. I mean, go out to lunch every day. And you can't do that. You know, I mean, you could treat yourself every now and then, but it's good to bring your own lunch, bring your own baked chicken, broccoli, salads, whatever you like, whatever your meal plan is. Bring that to work. Set the example. Lead by example. And you won't get tempted. Because you have something. Now, you have to make the right choice. Now, if you bring, say you bring your lunch to work, you brought a salad to work, and coworkers say, hey, let's go to Papa Do's, or that's something in Texas, Papa Do's, or let's go to Chili's, that's worldwide, let's go to Chili's for lunch. You have to make the choice then, because now you have something in front of you, but somebody's coming and saying, let's go to Chili's and get that 2 for $20, you know what I'm saying? So you have to make the correct choices at this time. So temptation, it's going to come. You're going to be tempted. You're going to have somebody come and say, let's go to lunch. Let's go to dinner. Let's have a drink. Let's go get dessert. Let's get, you know, all this. You're going to have, and you have to make the right choice. Not saying that you can't go. I mean, if you want to, if you enjoy that person's company, eat your lunch on the way there in the car and, you know, just sit down and have a glass of water and you still could converse and have, and be good company. Don't seclude or isolate yourself. You don't want to do that, but know what to do. You know what I'm saying? So when you go inside of Chili's, you won't be tempted because you're full by your lunch that you already ate. Hit the second question. If you binge for a few days during your diet. I had this problem once again when I was on my yo-yo period for 3 or 4 years. I would be so good and diligent through the week, Monday through Friday. I would follow whatever diet plan I was on. But come Saturday and Sunday, I thought that was my get out of jail free pass. I would cut up. I would eat whatever, however. And that always threw me off of track. Always. Always. And then come Monday again, I'm starting from square one. And that was a vicious cycle that I couldn't break for 3 or 4 years. I could not break this cycle. Monday through Friday, I would do so good. Weekend come, I would fall off, and then I'd have to start back again on Monday and see no progress. And my reason why I didn't see any progress was because I was cutting the food on Saturday and Sunday. So I had to break that cycle. And when I got serious last year in 2011, I broke that cycle. And how I broke it, I went to the gym on Saturday and Sundays. I worked out on the days that I cut a food on before. And one thing about me, if I work out, I'm not going, if I burn 400 calories, 600 calories, I'm not going to mess that up. You know what I'm saying? Because I didn't put in work. I didn't got up early in the morning. I done put in work. I done sweated like a beast. Went hard in the gym. So I'm not going to mess that up by going to Mickey D's. You know what I'm saying? Because it's not worth it to me. And you have to get that same mind frame. Whatever your diet is or whatever your workout routine is, if you have one, you have to feel that this is not worth it. This candy bar, this Snickers, these M&Ms, this Big Mac, this fries, this soft drink is not worth it to me. Not for the calories that I burn or not for the work that I put in. And that's what got me off my binging days. Cheat days, I didn't even do that last year. But prior when I was on my yo-yo, cheat days, I would call it a cheat day or whatever during the week when I was really messing up. And, you know, you don't want to even do that. You don't want to have a cheat day. You don't want to have a cheat day. And you really don't want to binge. But if you have to, if you catch yourself messing up, make it a one meal thing. Don't make it a day full of mistakes. Make it a one-time mistake. If you're caught out somewhere and you have absolutely nothing to eat and you have to go to one of these fast food restaurants, make a healthy choice, but make it a one-time thing. Don't think that, oh man, I ate Wendy's, so for dinner I could eat McDonald's, or for dinner I'm going to eat some pizza because I ain't already messed up, so I might as well just mess it up all day. You have to change your mindset. Make it a one-time thing and try to get back on track as soon as possible. And try not to be caught without something alternative with you, as far as a snack or something, a bottle of water. If you're feeling hungry, you caught up out on the other side of town, drink some water. Drink some water, some crackers or something lightweight. But if you absolutely have to cheat and binge, we just have to cheat, make it a one-time thing, because 500, 600 calories is a drop in the bucket compared to you eating 2,000 calories a day. You know what I'm saying? You could get back on track. You could get back to where you were if you just messed up one time, a meal that's about 500, 600 calories. But if you eating a whole day worth of $2,500 calories, that's a long way. You know, that's pounds right there. You know, so you have to, then you're gonna feel like you're defeated, and you know some people let the emotions and whatnot get to them, and you'll feel like you're defeated, and you'll get back in that rut. Well, man, I done messed up already, so I might as well. It'll throw you off. So instead of making it a day, make it a one-time thing. And that goes for holidays. That's how I get through holidays. Thanksgiving last year, I participated. I ate a little of this, a little. I didn't make a whole big plate or nothing, but I ate a little of this, a little of that one time. I made it a one-time meal instead of a day full of pinging out. Same thing on Christmas, one time. A little of this, a little of that in moderation. And made it a one-time thing, and that's what got me through the holidays. So you just have to change your mindset on those days that you know you're going to mess up, or your binge days. If you have like I was, the weekend girl, if you was a weekend binger, work out. Go for a walk. Go for a bike ride. Go swimming in summertime. Do something. Get active. Burn some calories. Sweat. Go hard on those days, and it'll totally take your mind off of, I want to eat. So that concludes this video. I want to thank JBells1. This was a great question. It really hit home for me because I went through this a whole lot. So this really hit home, and I hope this helped you out. Thanks.